In this tutorial, we are going to see how we can build a website quickly just using WordPress on Gutenberg editor and not using any other editor like Elementor, Divi or Beaver. For this, I am going to use a starter theme which is called Kadence theme. It has the free version available and you can actually use it to build any website from smaller to medium scale or maybe some bigger sites also. Assalamu alaikum and hi guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Adnan Ahmed. If this is the first time you are visiting my channel, please click on the subscribe icon and click the bell icon so you will never miss the video in the future. Okay, let's jump to the computer screen to start building the website in WordPress only using its Gutenberg editor. Okay, to start building a website just in WordPress using Gutenberg editor, we are going to use a starter theme which is called Kadence theme. Now I'm going to install that theme here, add new, and we need to search Kadence. It is a free theme built on Gutenberg blocks, but they have the premium version also which has some premium blocks there. You can check it on their website. For now I'm just going to install this free version. Okay, once the theme is installed, going to activate. And okay, once you activate the theme, you will see it is giving a message here, install Kadence starter templates. I'm clicking on this button. Okay, once this is activated, we have the option to choose a builder which is the native Gutenberg builder, or we can also use the Elementor. But for this tutorial, I'm not going to use any of the builder. I'm just working in the Gutenberg builder. Okay, now we have that starter template options. You can choose any of these theme which have this membership button here. We need to purchase it. So we're looking some free one. Let's say for the sake of this video, I'm just using this one, web agency. Okay, clicking on this one. Once you click on this, you will see some option here. We can change it later, but we can choose any of the color scheme from here, color palette you can say. There are number of good options here. Okay, maybe I like this one. And likewise, you can choose any of the font here. Let's say I am clicking this Montserrat here, and then I am going to import the site, or you can actually import the single page. If you are going to do a single page, you can have this option here, what page you want to import, or we can actually import the full site also. Okay, I am clicking it. It is showing what we are going to do in this. We choose this color palette here and this font here, and now clicking this start importing. And meanwhile it is working. You can see it will check for any of the plugin required or anything else like files, CSS, etc. Okay, now the template is imported. Now finishing this site. Okay, as soon as you click it, you can see full site is imported with pretty much everything in it. You can see the other pages. And services. Now you see how easy it is to make a website. You can actually just change the content, and you can put this website live also, or maybe you can add the sections, whatever you want to add it in this Kadence template. Let's say we are going to this homepage and see what is behind on this page. Okay, now you can see this is the template. If you click any of this part, let's say I click on it, and you will see a block is highlighted, and you can actually see this from this outline, or you can say three bars icon here. At the moment you selected this advanced heading, and this section is selected. Okay, if you already using some builders like Elementor or Beaver or DB, you have seen that they have some main sections. On the top, they have that container. In the container, there are rows, and then there are blocks or columns, you can say. Same like if you can see here, it has the topmost row, and then it is a container for this section. And then there is a section which are actually the columns here. Now what we can do, we can actually change this section, or maybe add some new blocks here. If you want to add some new block, click on this plus icon, and here we have that on the top, this Kadence block. These are some pre-built blocks in the Kadence themes. For free version, there are only a few ones there, but if you purchase a premium, there are some other premium blocks are available. And underneath it, these are the blocks which are present in the Gutenberg if you didn't install the Kadence theme. And media and design, let's say I'm trying to add some block here, or maybe we can say a button from here. I just need to drag and drop wherever I want to add it. Now you see it is a very basic button. We can style it. To style it, you need to click, and when you click it, you have some options highlighted on the right hand side. First of all, we are going to add some text on the button. Let's say we call it contact us. And after that, we want to style this button. For this, maybe we can increase this text size. You can see here, as soon as I'm dragging this slider, text size is changed. Next, we can change its color. You can select the platy we have already selected, or we can actually change this color from this color selector here. And likewise, we can change the background color. Maybe I am going to make it background like this. And if you want to change its hover style, you can change it from here. Background color is this, and text color is this. You can make it something else if you want to. Now you can see. And if you want to add some border here and border radius. So this is how we can work it in the Gutenberg editor. It is not very difficult. Almost all the options are like the ones we are using in other builders. Let's say you want to copy the style of this button, which is already present in the theme. You need to click on this button. Then you have this copy and paste icon here, copy paste style icon here. Just copy it, copy style, and same like clicking on this button, and then clicking on this icon again, and paste the style. And you see it is the same button, but width is full width of that column. And here you can see actually there are two columns here. If I can show you, you see one column and the second column, and you can also see from this three bar icon here. You can see there is again a row layout, and then a section, and then a first button on the left and the second button on the right. Next thing we can see in this tutorial here, actually there are too many options, which I guess is too much for this video to cover. I'm just giving you a quick brief on how we can use this Gutenberg without using any other theme builder. Okay, next thing is you can also reuse any of the section which is already built on one page, and then we can use it on the other pages also. Okay, let's say this is that ready to grow your business, a call to action section in here. Now we want to use it on any other page. For this I need to click on this section, and just to confirm, we have clicked that row layout. Yes, it is the row layout. And then I can click on this icon here, menu icon here, and add to reusable blocks, we can say. And here I can call it ready to grow section, and just update it. And it is saying if you want to update the page and the reusable block, yes, I want to update both of these. Now what I am going to do, I am going to add another page. And here if I want to add that block which I already saved, I need to click this plus icon. You will see this reusable block, and now I am going to drag and drop or click it. It will add to this page, and just preview it or publish it if you want to do. And you can see this block is here. Now if I update this block which is already present on this part on the home page, it will automatically update on the other page also. And just update it. You can see it is asking me if you want to update the block which is a reusable block. Yes, I want to, and I saved it. Now if I go to the other page where I already added that reusable block, the content will be updated automatically. You can see here it is updated. Now if I change it something else, save it. I missed the part here. Selected, and now save. Now I need to refresh it again, and you see the changes are there. So it is a good thing if you added that reusable block on multiple pages, you need to change on one instance, and it will be updated on each page. Next thing we can see is the responsive part on this Gutenberg. If you select some section, okay, now I selected this one, and then you will see these icons here. You can see the tablet one, it will look like this. Okay, and for mobile it is pretty much the same like tablet. And if we selected that row under it or section, we can say, let's say I am selecting this one, and I want to change for mobile. Okay, let's say on mobile maybe you want to hide this picture and this column also. I'm selecting this picture, and then I need to select its column. For this, easy is to just click on that top icon, and then we can do it. And this is the one, and then we are going to visibility settings, and from visibility settings we can hide on mobile and just preview it. Okay, it is there. For desktop, if we go to mobile, you see that picture section is gone from here. Okay, likewise if you want to keep it, but you wanted the picture should appear first and then that text for this section appear after it, For this we can do selecting that block here, this one, this section here, and outline, and then this section. And for this I want it to appear after the picture, and here I can say it has the order 2 for mobile, and for this picture section here again going to outline and then section, and it need to be 1, and just update it and see on the mobile what will happen. Now you can see after the team up section we have that image and then that about us section, but if we see it normally, now it is about us section is first and then the picture is on the right hand. So good feature again here. You can easily apply it. It is a very basic intro to the Gutenberg editor. There are many options available. You can just play with it, start building a website. If you like the content, please give me a thumbs up. And if you have any questions, write me in the comment section. Till next video, I am signing off. Bye.